So today I wanted to make a video on what is in my nursing bag. Nursing essentials that I carry to work with me every single day in my bag. So first of all, this bag is from Sephora. This is my, you know, just go to, I grab whatever. Whatever will fit everything inside of it. No Vera Bradley for me, no initials on the outside stitched in. It's just some bag. So right now I'm using this one and we'll go over what is inside. First is my handy dandy stethoscope. Of course, you've got to listen to your cardiac, lung, and gastric sounds. So I have that. I also have a pouch. I like to keep all of my pens, highlighters, Sharpies, all of that inside of a bag. And I have like all different kinds of colors of everything. But I found that when I kept it in the bottom of the bag itself, I would end up losing some or they would get broken in the bottom of the bag. So I just keep it in a pouch. It's so much easier and so much more organized. I also have lotion. It is so essential that you bring lotion to work with you because you are constantly washing your hands. Eventually that sanitizer like builds up and makes you feel like sticky and gross. So you're always washing your hands at work and they will get to the point to where they like crack and bleed. I mean, seriously chafed hands. So carry your fave lotion, something like heavy duty that's really, really gonna moisturize. So I carry lotion with me. Scissors. We need to cut tape. We need to cut all kinds of things. You may need to cut like some packaging open. So like cut bracelets off, anything. Carry your scissors with you. They come in handy lots throughout the shift. Also, I have this book. My aunt got this for me after I graduated. I don't know if you all can see it. It's like a critical care book because I am a critical care nurse. I work in a neuro ICU. So it tells you all different kinds of things. Like it's all categories on the bottom. Very, very helpful. I actually use this book a lot in school. It was like super small. You can easily flip through. It has cardiac rhythms, like all kinds of information here, like information on medications, everything. But I almost never pull it out at work, like never. I think that maybe when I very, very first started nursing, I would pull it out and I'd be like, oh, I'm just gonna read stuff so I can stay up on knowledge. But I mean, you really learn by doing. So I kind of just have this in there. If you're in school, I would recommend this for you. But yeah, I don't know. Or if you're studying for like your CCRN or something. But I rarely use it. Also, I have folders of information. I used to carry a huge binder in my bag from my last shop where it was like, if you worked in critical care, whatever specialty you worked in, they gave you a big binder of information that you could read through on your own. Never used it. So it was just kind of just taking up space. And then these are actually kind of doing the same thing. They're from my travel assignments. And so any information that they give me when I first get there, I always keep it with me just in case. Information on the policies, information on where to find things on campus, or where to find things on whatever web server they use. So they come in handy while I'm at the assignment. I'm a travel nurse, by the way. But after I leave, they really don't. So those come and go. I also use this. So this is a clipboard, but it folds in. I never fold it because I like my papers to be straight. But if you look on the back, there's tons of information, like helpful information, just in case you forget something. There's labs, there's how to measure an EKG, all types of helpful stuff. So that's on the back. I rarely ever look at it. I mean, I'm telling you, after you all start working, these things will become ingrained in your mind. But for new nurses, this was really, really great. Somebody gave me this too. I don't remember who. But yeah, there's lots of helpful stuff on here as a new nurse. And then my report sheet. This is a blank one. I have maybe four different sheets. I had two different sheets that I used when I was back home in Kentucky, and then I have just gotten sheets along the way. I have a sheet from St. Louis, I have a sheet from where I'm working now in Alexandria, Virginia. So, yeah, all of the report sheets go here. This is what I write on my handy dandy clipboard, because if you just have a piece of paper, it can get wet. You can lay it in something, you can leave it in someone's room. This is kind of hard to forget. Also, I have this ringlet of helpful ways to document. It's kind of similar to this, but one hospital gave this to me and I just kept it because it really emphasized their policies and procedures. So I think that that's why I kept it, because policies and procedures change every single hospital you go to. Chapstick. Chapstick. So I keep chapstick with me throughout my shifts. There are literally like four of them at the bottom of this bag, but I like am constantly like every full assessment, like every 4 hours, probably every 4 hours, I'm putting on my chapstick. So lotion and chapstick are really, really big. I keep my own hand sanitizer in here too, but I mean, you really don't need it. And then a charger cord. At work, I mean, you're there for 12, 13 hours. So your phone may die. And I mean, I'm telling you, this comes in handy. Like, this is small things. And then lastly, a book. I take a book with me to work. 30-minute breaks, and then sometimes you have time for 15s. If you work at a facility that's gracious enough to give you a break, because we all know as nurses, sometimes you're in the corner scarfing down food, you don't have time, your patient is coding, or such and such is happening, and you don't even have time to chill for 30 minutes. But if you do, there are rare days when you might. So I just keep one with me just in case I have time, because I love to read. But yeah, also, I have a drug card in there. My first hospital that I worked at gave me this drug card, and it is so helpful. If you can find something like this out there, it literally goes through every single drip that we started in the ICU. And I've only seen it at that particular hospital, but it goes through every single drip that we have, and then some of them we actually mixed ourselves on the floor, and so it tells you how much exactly to put inside of a 100 ml bag or a 250 bag or something like that. So it was super duper helpful. And then it also tells you like different side effects, like, oh, this prolongs the QT or anything like that. So I love this. Love, love, love this. Unfortunately, different hospitals use different dosage systems sometimes. So sometimes it doesn't really come in handy anymore, which is why it's at the bottom of my bag, even though it has a place where it can clip to my name badge. So yeah, those are all of the things that I feel like are my essentials. I take also a lunchbox with me and water for sure, because you want to make sure that you're drinking throughout your shift since you're there for such a very long time and you're just running all over and you can forget to like drink a full glass of water. So yeah, but those are all the things that are in the actual bag itself. I hope that this helps you all. Thanks for watching.